Welcome to the YouTube video lecture series of the subject Basic Electrical Engineering. Myself Pankil sir, and in previous videos we have started unit number 3 transformers. So in this video we are studying about the topics that are the basic working principle of a transformer and EMF equation of single phase transformer. So let's begin with this. So let's study first the working principle of a transformer. So to understand the working principle of a transformer, you need to understand this diagram. In this diagram, we have taken one core, that is a rectangular shaped core. And in this rectangular shaped core, we have mentioned two windings here. And that two windings are the primary winding and the secondary winding. This winding is known as the primary winding and another winding is known as the secondary winding. Primary winding is usually connected with the source of energy of which you want to increase or decrease the level of a voltage. And secondary winding is connected with the load to which you want to supply the increased or decreased voltage. So basically V1 is the supplied voltage to the primary winding and V2 is the voltage, output voltage to the load, and I1 and I2 are the current flowing through both the primary and secondary winding respectively. Flux phi will start linking with this core, inside this core, and E1 and E2 are the self-induced EMF in these two windings. So now let's see the working principle of a transformer. So whenever we are connecting the AC voltage source V1 to the primary winding, then this primary winding is having the electric current, and that is the AC alternating form of current, and which produce the changing magnetic field in this primary winding. So whenever you are supplying the AC current to any primary winding, then the changing alternating flux will be produced in the primary. Second step is this changing magnetic field gets associated with the secondary winding through the soft iron core. So basically flux will be produced here, but this flux will link towards the secondary winding through this magnetic core. Third step is hence the magnetic flux links with the secondary coil changes, because before that no magnetic flux was linking with the coil and now some amount of flux has been started linking with it. So the magnetic flux linking with this coil is changing, and we know that Faraday's law, whenever the flux linkages linking with any coil is changing, then EMF will be induced in that coil. So which induces EMF in the second, because before no flux was linking with it and now some amount of flux is linking with it, so we can say that some amount of EMF will start producing in the secondary side. So this was the very basic working principle of any single phase transformer. Now let's derive the EMF equation of a transformer. So to understand the EMF equation of a transformer, we need to consider one simple diagram, and this simple diagram is a sinusoidal waveform of one cycle. So this is a one cycle, and this one cycle, to complete this one cycle, it is taking capital T time, or you can say that 1 upon F time, and this is the graph of EMF versus time, and this one cycle is having the maximum value of EMF, or you can say flux here, and this time to reach the maximum flux is T by 4, and T by 4 is equals to 1 upon 4F also. So this is the very basic sinusoidal waveform of the alternating flux. So now let's start deriving the EMF equation of a single phase transformer. So let's say that N1 is the number of turns of primary winding, N2 is the number of turns in the secondary winding, phi n is the maximum flux in the core, and phi is equals to Bm into A, where this F is nothing but the frequency of AC in hertz. So N1, N2, phi and F are the assumed terms for this diagram. Now, as shown in figure, flux increasing from its zero value and it is reaching its maximum value in 1/4 of the cycle. That means in 1/4 of F seconds. So we can say that the average rate of change of flux, so the maximum flux is phi m, and to reach that maximum flux it is taking time as 1 upon 4 f. This is f. So So if 4F is taken on the numerator, then it will be 4F5 wave. So this is the rate of change of flux. But we know that the rate of change of flux per turn means induced EMF in what? Because Faraday's law states that the amount of induced EMF in any coil is directly proportional to the rate of change of flux. So this is rate of change of flux. So this is nothing but the induced EMF in that winding. So the average EMF per turn is given by this formula, 4F into 5M in volts. So now let's say that if flux phi varies sinusoidally, then the RMS value of EMF is obtained by multiplying the average value by form factor. Because we know that form factor is equals to RMS by average. So if you want to find the RMS value, then you have to multiply the average value by form factor. And the form factor is given by 1.11. So let's find the RMS value of EMF per turn. So the EMF per turn was having the equation 4F5 and the form factor is 1.11. So 1.11 into 4 will give you 4.44 F5 volts. So this is the RMS form of EMF per turn. Now if you want to find the RMS value of the induced EMF in the whole primary winding, then you have to multiply this induced EMF per turn with the number of primary turns. So if we multiply this equation with primary number of turns N1, then this equation is the induced EMF equation of the primary side. So E1 is equals to 4.44 FN1 phi M. And instead of phi, you can put BM into A also. Similarly for the secondary winding. For secondary winding, you have to place the number of turns of the secondary winding, that is number of turns in N2. So it's seen that from equation number 1 and equation number 2, if we are taking ratio of these two equations, so it will be E1 by E2 and it will be equals to N1 by N2. So we can say that this ratio will be always equals to 4.44 F5M. So we can say that EMF per turn in both the windings are same. So in ideal transformer at no load condition, we can say that the applied voltage is equals to EMF induced in that winding, and the EMF induced in the secondary winding will be equals to the terminal voltage at the load, where V2 is known as the terminal. Now let's see some definition related to this EMF equation, and that definition is voltage transformation ratio. So the voltage transformation ratio can be obtained by dividing the equation 1 and 2. So E2 by E1 is equals to N2 by N1 and is equals to K. This is known as the transformation ratio. This constant K is known as the voltage transformation ratio. If number of turns of the secondary winding is greater than the number of turns of primary winding, that means if N1 is multiplied here, that means K will be greater than 1. Then we can say that the transformer is step up turns. But if secondary number of turns is less than the primary number of turns, then K will be less than 1. And if K is less than 1, then we can say that this is a step up transformer. And it is obvious that if the number of turns of secondary winding is less than the primary winding, then it will step down the voltage. If number of turns of the secondary winding is higher than the primary winding, then it will step up the voltage. So it is known as the step up transformer. So again, for an ideal transformer, input power will be always equals to the output power. So input power is nothing but V1 I1, output power is nothing but the V2 I2. So V1 I1 is equals to V2 I2. If we are taking ratio of V1 upon V2, then it will be I2 upon I1, and which is known as the 1 upon K. So this is the transformation ratio in terms of current. So basically we can say that transformation ratio K is equals to E2 by E1 is equals to V2 by V1 is equals to N2 by N1, but in case of current it will be I1 by I. So this is known as the transformation ratio. Next definition is the voltage regulation of a transformer. So voltage regulation can be given by this formula, no load voltage minus full load voltage divided by no load voltage at secondary side. So we can say that no load voltage at secondary side is V2 minus Vs. Here Vs represents the secondary winding voltage. So Vs at no load minus Vs at full load divided by Vs at no load. Now let's see the losses in a transformer. So in a transformer, we can say that there are different type of losses. So the type of losses are, first is the iron loss and second one is the copper loss. Iron loss is due to the magnetic material used to construct a transformer's core. So the iron loss is again having two types, and it is due to the core used. So first loss is the hysteresis loss and second loss is the eddy current loss. Hysteresis loss is having this equation, WH is equals to eta Bm raised to 1.6 F into V volts. And eddy current loss is given by this formula, WE is equals to P Bm square F square T square in volts. And the copper loss is due to the windings, because we are using copper in winding. So due to this copper, some amount of copper loss will be there. And it is given by this formula, I1 square R1 plus I2 square R2, because we are using two windings, primary winding and secondary winding. So there will be two types of loss in both the winding, that is the copper loss. So basically, total loss is distributed in iron loss and copper loss, and iron loss is further distributed in hysteresis and eddy current loss. If you want to find the efficiency of a transformer, then it is defined as, the efficiency of any electric machine is given by this formula, the output power divided by the input power, multiplying with 100% to obtain the answer in percent. Output power will be as it is. Instead of input power, you can say that output power plus losses occurred in that electric machine. So if you put the values of the losses in this equation and the power in this equation, then this output power is nothing but the power achieved by the load. So the secondary voltage is Vs, secondary current is Is, and the angle between them is theta. So we can say that output power is Vs Is cos theta. In denominator, it will be Vs Is cos theta, but two type of losses will be added, that is the copper loss and there is a iron loss, or you can say core loss multiplying with 100%. There is no frictional or windage loss available in transformer, because I said that transformer is a static device, no rotating part is there, so no mechanical type of losses will occur in this transformer. So this was all about the transformer and construct a working principle of a transformer. Thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned.